So to help with this sharp area, I'm gonna draw some stars in. I quite like putting in hidden stars into the work a little bit every now and again. Once again, it's repetition of shape. So like the star shapes sort of represent this corner bit. So what it's doing is it's pulling your eye down now. So as you can see, like, lead your eye down. So now I want to start introducing more colours into this vase, sort of strengthen it a bit as well. And, you know, you could just keep going over it and over it. Could add a layer of tissue paper, more gesso. It's just about slowly building up the image to get what you want. So I might start and draw some of this sunflower. Not all of it, but just a suggestion of it, like I said. Maybe just want to have one this way. And what I might do is I might fill in one, this area, the positive space, we'll paint it forward, because there's all of these are basically negatives. So to make your eye jump backwards and forwards, you can paint in some of these areas to create a positive space, so there's a layer between these two surfaces, and I'll show you what I mean. So for example, we might fill in this space. And I might actually just fill in this one. And just put a suggestion here of it. Doesn't have to be. Probably that's a bit dark, but I can paint over white. When it dries, maybe I need to paint over it a bit white. But, so as you can see, the whole sunflower looks completely different everywhere you look. This side is different to this side. This section, this corner section here is different to this top corner section. So when I break things in half, so I even break them into quarters. And that's different to that corner. So you're creating areas of interest for your eye, and that's what makes a painting really interesting, especially a mixed media layered painting like this. And then changing your style, like using part stencils, creates another layer, another level of interest, and then you can combine them together. Don't forget, you can just paint over the top and to emphasize sections as well. and like for this one as well. I could rework this a bit, I'm not 100% happy with it, but it's getting there. And again, there's different flowers up here, and you just create layers in the flowers. Now the background, I'm still got to do a lot of work on, and I sort of want to create shadow, like a bit of depth and shadow depth. So I'm just going to scribble in some black and then come and paint over it. And what you can do is you can just repeat things subtly. So it's sort of, that's a repeat of that. And that's sort of a repeat of the square, which reinforces the painting, like the squares in the actual whole painting. So you're always giving the brain information. And so like the stars make it jump up to here, and then there's repetition, because there's repetition of shape. And then there's repetition of colour, so your eye jumps from the red up to these type of flowers. And then across here, because it's different to everything else, and then down here. So you like your eye, and then like these drag your eye down a bit, back into here, and then it jumps across. Yeah. And just subtle bits of writing. I'm going to keep working with this painting, because it's not one I can just do in actually probably 1 or 2 days. To actually get it to a stage where I'm really happy with it will take, you know, more than 1 day. I mean, I could rework this area, and if you're not happy with the section, leave the bits you like and get rid of the bits you don't like. So I could paint that whole section out again and rework over the top. But don't paint it completely out, because you want to show the history that you've created in the work, and that's important, to keep the history. People want to see a progression in the work. They want to see the build-up of layers and depth, and you know, that's what you do. Now I could come back, because the actual background isn't too, it's obviously not a lot of depth in here yet, but I'll come back in with shading and tones to see I could create more depth behind some of these flowers by adding a darker blue right at the back. You know, there's lots of different ways. Like I could darken this area up around here, try and fade out some of that blue a bit as well. But this is just to give you an idea of my version of Van Gogh's sunflowers, what I've done, just in the space of, I don't know, it was a couple of hours since I've started. And the possibilities that you can do. Just got to play around. So what I'm going to do is add another type of flowers here as well. But I'm going to paint them straight over the top of these particular flowers. Just to help fade things back. Just got to wash my brush a bit better.